So we're still animating the thylacine, but now we've arrived at a point where we can actually incorporate stuff that makes it really interesting to look at, because before we've only done the real basic stuff that is simply required for it to work roughly in game, but now we can do give it some character. So for example, by we can start by adding the characteristic yawning with this a wide open gape. So we get a stand idle and we copy it and rename it yawn. And now we get to the middle and we can open the drawer. So I think 120 degrees, I think I've read that value. It simply stretches it too far. I'd say something like 90 degrees is much more plausible. So we'll stay there and we can clean up the rotations up here because I didn't lock draw rotations like I did for the lungs, so we can get some nasty rotations here. But those are essential, for example, for chewing. If we wanted it to chew, we would also include a rotation from the top, a little bit of, at least. Okay, so now we have to add a keyframe here for this one because it was edited in the properties. Okay. So now when we think about a yawn, the speed of opening and closing is not the same. So we have it opens really fast and then it closes slowly, but still slower than our stand cycle length at the moment allows for. Kind of like this at the moment, we bring the head a bit forward and now yeah, sort of like this. So now perhaps it looks best if we have them in sync here, the head and the jaw. And then we've got to change this pose here a bit. So this is not really yawning in the sense of being tired, but sort of an aggressive yawn as a defensive signal. So we might also call it stand defensive or something like that. We could add a bit more spine motion now because it looks relatively still. And of course we simply can, if we, because this isn't supposed to be looping continuously, so we can do stuff with a bit of liberty. So we don't want to have it all too still and all too stiff, so we can let it do some more interesting stuff too. So kind of like this, so it gets some motion. And we can let the ears, perhaps in a dog-like fashion, we can, cats also do it, kind of put the ears towards the head because it's pissed off. So we get rid of our old ear keys. Okay, so we've got our yawning. Okay, then we can go back to stand and think about the next next animation. Or we can do sniffing the air. Oh, I think I renamed the stand, so gotta rename it back to stand idle and make copy. Okay. So here we use our bone a bit more, our IK bone chain control. Simply because it's really nice to make use of for this kind of purpose. So we can use it to give our spine the motion we want. And doing so relatively quickly by not editing all the bones manually for all frames. Oops, that got kind of fucked up here. Okay. Okay, so it didn't really work out as expected. So we have to do some counterbalancing to make it work. Yeah, perhaps that one's good enough now if we slow it down. Okay, now if we first step to making it look like it was sniffing is we go ahead and add some more lung keys so we get lung activity. Okay. And now we can look a bit more at the spine. So here it bent really strangely. Okay, now that looks pretty believable. Okay. Now some more in between keys to give the head some idea of sniffing, so we can go here and go here and simply rotate it upward a bit further, then we have those short faces of fast motion coupled with those longer phases of slower motion. And now we do the same before our keys slightly, so we get it two times a sniff kind of thing. And now again here, and now we've got a relatively wiggly head going on round, like it was sniffing. But now I don't like what the spine does, it because it moves too wildly around. So I'll just take the first spine bone and count it, and now it looks relatively still, but still interesting, and the head does its stuff nicely. So that's where we want to be. Now the tail is relatively still, so we can go and grab all of those tail keyframes. Oops, I had some more in the selection. Okay, so 0.5 and duplicate them. So now the tail is moving at the original speed again. And perhaps we can incorporate a little bit more pelvis activity, because the pelvis here seems to be relatively stiff. Okay, now it's better. Okay. So now just a few finishing touches. Let's simply put a key for the jaw in between here. So we simply take one and copy it, and again have those kind of mimic those patterns of the head movements. Just give it a still face in the middle between two of those. Okay. Nice. Okay, back to stand idle and add a new one. This time we can, let's say, do a shake. Okay, this is also relatively tricky here, because we have to get a plausible timing. So we still have our individual centers as pivot. And now we select the complete spine, and maybe we can also select tail and pelvis. I haven't. Yeah, we can. It still works well. We have to go downward a bit, and count it on the pelvis a tiny bit. Okay, now second frame, we do the same in the opposite direction, but not as strong. well, kind of, perhaps we can have one relatively strong cycle and then we go to the other sign and make it relatively weak. Okay, so we have to duplicate it because we need more keys to work with. Okay. Yeah, that's kind of getting there. So back to the front. Now I'm kind of changing the neck, sort of stretching the head, so we get a more interesting look, so it doesn't look too much like the stand pose. And it goes down here and up here, and we don't want this up down, and we have to check where the pelvis starts. So we slowly want to go back up. Further down, not so far down. Okay, and more stuff for the head. More shaky. Maybe speed it up a bit. Don't really like the way the head looks up all the time. Perhaps it was better the way it was before. Probably was. So we'll have to counter here the neck. Whenever it goes upward, we want to bring it down with a bit. Most of it comes from the neck, but also something bit comes from the head itself. So that's nice, that's nice, that's nice. Okay. Maybe speed it up a further, so again 0.75. Yeah, I think that looks more like real shaking. Okay. Stand idle. Go back and make a new copy. This time we can. Yeah. Well, what could we still do? So perhaps a call. Okay. I think I've read that. The thylacine was supposed to have sort of a high pitch or two high pitch calls after another, so kind of yip yip or something like that. So we try to represent the sound, of course, in our animation, so it seems to blend nicely and matches. So we get a general pose for the call. Kind of like this. So we have call, then sort of close, and then go back to calling again. So we make it a little bit longer, and we copy this one here, and then we copy these here, and then we can change our intermediate a bit. Go down. So say, yep, and close it here. Oh no. A short phase of closure, and here the jaw is of course supposed not to open at the first few frames of the animation, but only when it gets in place. And again here it should close by here, I think. Okay. Pelvis keys, because they are sort of in the way. Perhaps we can remove them all so we get a real nice smooth blend. Get our tail, and we kill those keyframes and add new ones, and then here add a bit of rotation, and here bring it to the middle, and here rotate it back to the other side. Okay. So I think it kind of lacks a force. So first we want to have our lungs once again open and close. So lungs open, close, close, open. Close, open. Okay. Now we can. Oh yeah, we can add some rotation from the top, so one looks in this direction and the second one looks to the other side. So one, two, make this one not as strong. Okay, maybe give it a bit more head, neck raising. And here too. And perhaps give the neck a bit of a leg so it quickly goes upward. Oh yeah, that really helped. Now, the only thing I'm not really happy with is that the spine really stays in place, so that it should raise high above the rest. We don't want those pelvis keys. So the problem is here, we're almost at the limit of a reasonable. You know, you see the arms are beginning to stretch in a weird way. So we can't go higher than this. But what we can do is, oh yeah, we can add a kind of a counter rotation here of the pelvis to sort of make it more like a moving thing, and that also helped quite a lot. Now it's not as stable here anymore around the shoulder region, and it looks more alive. So now you have to imagine sort of yip yip or something like that. I'll have to sort of design some kind of sound by overlaying different calls so it looks plausible. Okay. New animation. Oh yeah, so now I've forgotten about one last required animation set, and that is the turns for stand. So we have to have a stand turn left 90, where we essentially do nothing more than centering the cursor and setting it here to 3D cursor, and then we rotate the whole thing by minus 90. And of course now we have to set the extend mode of the channels back to constant. So now you go here, and then it suddenly, or then it stays there. So what we have is this. So this will be our turning animation. So now we have to consider how the head and neck and spine should look, and the tail, and then what to do with the feet. So first the neck and spine kind of stuff. So we go back to our individual centers cursor, and we select the whole spine and kind of curl it up then we do the same for the tail and pelvis in the opposite direction. So we get a nicely bent spine. Okay. So now that looks good enough from the top, but of course the legs are causing serious slithering here. So we go back to now we have a look at the legs. So we have to implement steps now. So the arms are going to have a larger range of motion here than the back legs, slightly larger only, so we'll probably have to do two steps for each, but we'll see how it evolves. So the first thing that we want to do is we add a keyframe here for them all in the middle. Now we'll see if we can work with that. Probably not, so we move it to a better place already, because the middle pose was sort of messed up. Okay, now we see if we can use this pose to get to in only half the speed. And we need to have a look at our bones, and it seems to work without stretching it. So we go, and now we take the other hand and duplicate it, so we have left step, right step. Okay, left step, right step, then again left step. Left step, right, left step, right step, left step, and we keep the right one here in place. Left, right step. Okay, step, steps. Okay. Now go here to. We don't need them at the moment, so we want to rotate those keys a bit. Pause, because they are somehow not really in line. Now they are. Okay. And now we do the same approach basically for the feet. So first we test, can we get there in 10 frames? Yes, we can, but first we have to move the right one, because that one moves first. And again, check here with the leg bones. Yeah, that works. And so we have step, step, and still, then still, step, still, step. Okay, and now here we have step. No, still, step, still, step, step, still, step, still. Okay, so now we've got our step setup complete, and now we can simply use this layout that we have to create the actual steps. So let's say 15, let's say 25, and we bring all of the bones in the areas where there is no pink. We bring them up and give them 25 degree rotation, and now we do the same for the outer face bones, so the other side. Okay, and now we have our steps in place. And it moves nicely. And that's pretty much the way it's supposed to look like. Those are really tricky because you easily get really confused with your legs if you don't use a really kind of organized way to create it, like I did here, really by dragging the frames where you want them to be, and then you get to something good. Otherwise it gets really messed up. Okay, so now we need turn left. Turn right 90 degrees, so we have to go back to stand idle, add a new one and call it stand turn right 90. Okay, first we set the keys to constant. Now we go to the end, 3D cursor 90. Yep. Okay. So now we add key for our controllers here. Move the hands a bit forward. Legs a bit backward. Okay, same procedure. Now we have to do it the other way around. So right hand gets to step first, then pause, then step. Step, pause, step. Okay, left hand pause first, then step, then pause. Step, step. Okay. And same with the feet. Left foot has to step first, then pause, then step. And here the same. So you always get to see this pattern. So that makes it relatively easy to solve this problem. It's more or less always the same if you're doing it with this method. Individual cursors again, individual centers, and move them up and rotate, and the same here. And we haven't bent the spine yet, so we're gonna do that now. Get them all and bend, and also bend the pelvis area and tail. And now that should we've got a problem here. Hand right hand has to be sped up a little bit to avoid being extremely stretched. So we have to go here and also speed this up, and this one too, so we don't get too many nasty overlapping. Okay, this way it looks approvable. It's not perfect, but it does the trick. Okay. So we could also do a stand turn 180 degrees, but that's quite a lot of work, and you could simply do that by playing two of those other turns one after another. So I think I'd avoid it and rather fix the task file to work with two 90 degree turns instead. Now, what can we do next? We can, for example, transfer this joining we've made to the line. Oops. To the line animation. So we take this one, and again we use the copy post buffer, and we go to lie idle, and we add a new one, call it lie idle yawn. And we go here and paste. So now we have to go back. Now we have to slow it down to fit with the yawning, and we also have to get the pose back from here. Because the rest pose of the head is different. Okay, so we'll have to change this around a little bit. Okay. Perhaps have it look even further upward, sort of like this. Yeah. And we can check with the texture view if we get strong distortions, but we don't, because we UV'd, or we created the UV map in a way to avoid such distortions even at wide stretches. So that was important, because otherwise we would have really strong stretching here And of course that would look not really good. Okay. So we can do... Oh yeah, we can do some cleaning animations. Like maybe licking the paws, something like that. So we have lie idle. And we can copy that, rename it to lie, let's call it lie lick paws. Okay, so this will be more of a challenge again in terms of animating. So first we need a pose that we can sort of use to get the rough idea of what we want to do. So that's the first thing that we do. So we go like this, and then we go, we can so okay. Now we've got this one, now we need a second one to sort of where it goes further backward. So it looks like it's actually moving along this its paw. Okay, now we can repeat this pose, at least here. We copy those keys here for the spine and for neck and head, and we go here and paste them here. Okay, now we got to make it longer, say 80 frames, and we copy this whole thing here, and then we can randomize it. And get this one back here for the end. So let's say we'll make it 100 frames long. We're gonna need that to make it look believable. Okay. So we've got... We've got a mistake with looping it. Okay. Okay, now what we want to do again is clean this action, because otherwise we might get problems. Oh, you see, we've already got a little problem here. Where does this come from? Okay, now it cleaned it. It didn't clean it before somehow, I think, because I didn't select all of the keys. But here we have something we don't want. Yeah. Because we had a one clean. And it already ends again here. So we're gonna copy it one more time from here. So we copy this phase here. And once more. Now we should have a long licking phase like this, yes. Okay, now we can make it more random. So we'll leave this one. Okay, that was already relatively nice, but we introduced a sudden curve here, and I think that was too strong, so we have to make this one longer, give it an extra 10 frames, and also here at the end. Want to see the control? I only want to see the controllers. Okay, now we want to open the drawer when it moves forward. So open, close, open, yeah, like this. We can also delete this key because it doesn't really make it better. Sort of a bit of fine tuning here. Trying to figure out what looks best and most plausible. Timing issues and other stuff as well. So I think we have it looks nice from the side. Relatively speaking. But it looks way too wiggly from the front. So we have to counter that a bit. So here again, kind of this IK train without a target makes it relatively nice to control this kind of problem, sort of to cure it. We can actually turn it around and have it have the jaw scratch. Scratch the head, actually. Why not? I mean, it seems only legit to do so to make it a bit more interesting. So we'll have a lick, and then we go to having it scratch. I think we have a little intersection here. Okay, I think now that's relatively nice. Okay, what else can we do for lying? We can have a lying animation where it looks around. So we can have lie look. We can have lie look left. And we have to slow it down a bit. Oops. And give it some kind of lasting effect, so it doesn't look straight back. Longer, probably. Oops. Yeah, I think that looks nice. Okay, we can simply duplicate it and mirror these here. Oops. No, we only want to mirror these. And we have to rename it back again. Oops. Copy, paste mirror. Copy, paste mirrored. And a quick test. Does it still look properly? Oh, we have to mirror the pelvis back. Okay, so now we've got quite a pile of animations already there, but really with no effort at all, we now have to make it even larger pile, because we need for all of our locomotion animes, like walk ahead, we need animations for turning, so we need, say, turning by 20 degrees or say by 40 degrees, and we need one turning to the left and turning to the right, and then you can see for each animation set that we have that moves forward, we get already four additional animations. So that would be quite of a pain in the ass to animate all of these manually. So I've written a little script that simply creates all of these on its own. So you don't have to do really anything. I'll just save it now, just to be sure. It might mess up. Okay, animation. So I've created a little scripts window down here. Scripts, animation, create turning animations. And then here you can specify which animation sets are the locomotion animations. So which should be used to create turn animations for. So we can't do that for things like standing there. It simply will look not good enough. Then here are the angles that we need, and it will create the negative angle as well and name it correctly. And these are sort of factors that I use to weigh the bending effect onto the spine. I've come up with these for the thylacine, so if you have another skeleton, you may want to adjust them, because each of these values is multiplied to the degree and the bones, and the more bones in your spine chain you have, the stronger the effect will be, so you would have to use smaller numbers perhaps, but you'll simply have to try it out. Okay, so we hit OK, and then we see in the console it's working, creating all those actions, and when it's done, and we can check them out. So here we have a swim to the left, to the right. So you see Here, this is the end position of the head, and the spine and the neck and the head bend, so the neck and head already look in the end position. So it's not just that the controllers are moved, but also the spine and the tail are bent, sort of to interpolate between the two. And now you see, we've got a quite an assortment of animations here, and now we could already perhaps try to compile it and export it for in-game usage, but I think we'll keep on adding some new ones. But we're getting there. So the end is near, sort of, at least.